Dear students, I welcome you all. Today I am going to talk about electron transport mechanism. As you all know, all organisms or cells need energy to survive and to carry out various physiological and biological activities. Growth of organisms or cell division also utilizes energy. Thus, each organism or cell needs energy to sustain its metabolism, which they obtain through different ways. Plants, as producers, trap solar energy during photosynthesis, which is utilized in the formation of glycoside bonds of sugar molecules, which are then broken down to release energy for their survival. Herbivores, in search of energy-rich compounds, feed on plants and a breakdown of the consumed food to release energy, while as carnivores feed on herbivores to get this energy or food. Decomposers get the energy-rich compounds from dead matter of plants and animals. In the eukaryotic world of plants and animals, the breakdown or oxidation of these energy-rich compounds is brought about sequentially in the cytoplasm and then in the mitochondrion, which is commonly referred to as the powerhouse of the cell, owing to the fact that here almost all of the energy is harvested from these compounds, resulting in the formation of ATP. Now, dear students, let's talk about a direction of electron transport and sequence of carriers in the electron transport chain. A reduction potential is the potential of a compound to accept electrons. A molecule with a low or negative reduction potential has a high potential to donate electrons, while as a molecule having positive reduction potential has a high affinity for electrons. In the electron transport chain, the two extreme values of standard reduction potential are for NADH and O2, with carriers having intermediate but highly ordered reduction potential values. The reduction potential of NADH is -320 millivolts, thus it is having a strong potential to donate electrons, while as the reduction potential of oxygen is +840 millivolts, thus it has a strong affinity for electrons. The reduction potential of carriers increases from NADH to O2, and the carriers are thus ordered in an ascending order of their reduction potential. This ascending order of standard reduction potential favors a directional and smooth flow of electrons from NADH to O2 through different carriers with specific reduction potential values. The reduction potential values of electron carriers in the electron transport chain basically determine their sequence or position in the electron transport chain, with carrier having lower or negative potential at the beginning of the chain, while as carriers with higher or positive reduction potential at the end of the chain. Besides, the electron carriers in the chain are highly specific in accepting electrons from and donating electrons to particular carriers with this specificity between carriers basically being governed by their standard reduction potential values. Dear students, one more aspect which needs mention is electron transport in the mitochondria is coupled to proton translocation. The redox potential is basically an index of electron affinity. In the electron transport chain, the electron transfer occurs stepwise between two adjacent carriers which form a redox pair. The electron transfer between two adjacent carriers differing in their reduction potential is associated with release of free energy. The extent or amount of energy which is released on such transfer is directly proportional to the difference in the redox potential of the two carriers. In the electron transport chain, there is a huge drop in the redox value of carriers across each of the three enzyme complexes, resulting in release of large fraction of free energy at these sites. These sites are commonly referred as energy harvesting sites. Each of these complexes harvests this free energy change by pumping protons across the inner membrane, generating an electrochemical gradient or proton motive force, which is exploited for ATP synthesis. The inner membrane of mitochondria is impermeable to protons, which move down the gradient from intermembrane space to the matrix only through FOFN complex, also called as ATP synthase. The energy released when protons come down the electrochemical gradient from a higher potential to a lower potential is utilized by ATP synthase to catalyze the phosphorylation of ADP to form ATP. Thus, electron transport in the electron transport chain is coupled to ATP formation. It is believed that NADH dehydrogenase complex and cytochrome BC1 complex pump 4 protons each per pair of electrons, while as cytochrome oxidase pumps 2 protons per pair of electron transfer donated by NADH. Succinate dehydrogenase complex deserves a special mention here. This complex doesn't pump protons, thus electrons from this complex miss the first complex or energy harvesting site, resulting in less proton translocation across the membrane. This is the reason why NADH oxidation yields 3 ATPs and FADH results in the formation of 2 ATP molecules only. The compounds such as ammonia and dinitrophenol, which can transport protons across the inner membrane, are called as uncouplers. The uncoupler steals protons from the intermembrane space and transport them into the matrix, thus eliminating the electrochemical gradient across the inner membrane and consequently uncouple ATP formation from electron transport. Dear students, now let us talk about the rate of electron transport or a respiratory control of electron transport. Uncouplers are known to neutralize, eliminate or flatten the electrochemical gradient across the inner mitochondrial membrane by ferrying translocated protons back into the matrix. Whenever this collapse of electrochemical gradient is brought about by the uncouplers, it results in an increased uptake of oxygen by the mitochondria because of a faster electron transport. Therefore, it becomes clear that the electrochemical gradient controls the pace of electron transport. When the electrochemical gradient across the inner mitochondrial membrane is decreased, the electron flow runs at the maximum pace, and when the electrochemical gradient is increased and becomes strong, the electron transport is very slow. Normally, electrochemical gradient is exploited for ATP synthesis, where protons move from intermembrane space into the matrix down the gradient through FOFN complex, also called as ATP synthase. When ATP synthesis is rapid, the electrochemical gradient is lowered rapidly, which causes a rapid electron transport. The rate of ATP synthesis also depends on the concentration of ADP and inorganic phosphate, which results from the breakdown of ATP, also expressed as ATP-ADP ratio. When the ratio falls, that is, when the utilization of ATP is increased, it increases the concentration of ADP and phosphate in the mitochondria. Therefore, increasing the substrate concentration for enzyme ATP synthase, which speeds its work of ATP synthesis by allowing a rapid flow of protons through it from the inner membrane space. This faster flow of protons into the matrix rapidly decreases or dissipates the electrochemical gradient, which results in an increased electron transport and increased NADH oxidation. Under such conditions, the rate of glycolysis and Krebs cycle is also increased, so to synthesize more NADH at a faster rate. In situations where ATP-ADP ratio is high, the concentration of ADP is less, ATP synthase activity remains slow, which is not efficient to suck proton flow down into the matrix and decreases the electrochemical gradient. In such situations, a high electrochemical gradient causes a very slow electron transport, which means a slow oxidation of NADH and consequently slow generation of NADH, that is, slow Krebs cycle and glycolysis. Now, one more aspect of the electron transfer in the electron transport chain is step-by-step transfer of electrons from NADH to O2. NADH is a strong electron donor with a negative reduction potential, as I have already mentioned, and oxygen is a strong electron acceptor with a positive reduction potential, which is indicative of its higher affinity for electrons. Thermodynamically, the direct transfer of electrons from NADH to oxygen is highly favored, but in the cell system, particularly in the mitochondria, this redox reaction or electron transfer involves multiple steps with involvement of multiple carriers. There is huge free energy drop in the redox reaction between NADH and oxygen, and if this reaction is allowed to go inside the cell, it will occur at an explosive pace with all the energy released in the form of heat. This direct transfer can thus prove disadvantageous or disastrous for the cell system, and this explains the reason why a step-by-step electron transfer mechanism or electron transport chain between NADH and O2 has been evolved by the living cells. The electron transfer in many small steps promises a set of wise favorable energy release, most of which is harvested and stored by the cell in the form of ATP. Now, let's talk about the inhibitors of electron transport chain. There are various substances which bind to specific carriers and inhibit and block the electron transport at specific sites in the electron transport chain. These inhibitors partly help scientists to deduce the sequence of carriers in the electron transport chain. These inhibitors inactivate specific carriers by leaving them unable to undergo reversible oxidations and reductions. After binding a specific carrier or component of electron transport chain, all the upstream carriers are reduced, while as all the downstream carriers remain in the oxidized state because these inhibitors block the electron transport ahead their binding site. The common inhibitors of electron transport are rotenone, amytal, antimycin A, cyanide, azide, and carbon monoxide. Amytal, barbiturate, and rotenone, a plant-based insecticide and fish poison, block the electron transport chain from complex 1 to coenzyme Q or ubiquinone and consequently prevent the utilization of NADH as a substrate. However, electron transport from FADH or complex 2 is not affected since it bypasses complex 1 and directly transfers electrons to coenzyme Q or ubiquinone. Antimycin A, one more inhibitor of the electron transport chain, an antibiotic obtained from streptomyces, binds complex 3rd and blocks electron transport between cytochrome B and cytochrome C1, thus not allowing electron transport from complex 3 to complex 4. This results in a blockade of electron transport chain with upstream components of chain in a fully reduced form and no onward electron transport O2. Cyanide and azide bind to the ferric form of heme iron of cytochrome A3, while as carbon monoxide binds to its reduced form. All these inhibitors also cause inhibition of ATP synthesis, as ATP synthesis is coupled to electron transport in the electron transport chain. Now, we do have some alternative pathways in plants. They are called as rotenone and cyanide resistant pathways in plants. The plant mitochondria is different from that of animals in having alternative pathways or bypasses for transport of electrons from NADH to O2. As discussed above, rotenone is a strong and specific inhibitor of NADH dehydrogenase complex, which on binding to complex 1 prevents oxidation of NADH and subsequent electron transport in the chain. Plants, however, do have some other additional NADH dehydrogenases which are insensitive to rotenone and are capable of oxidizing NADH or NADPH and transferring electrons to ubiquinone. These are called as type 2 dehydrogenases and are different from complex 1, which are called as type 1 dehydrogenases. However, type 2 dehydrogenases are not able to pump protons into the intermembrane space, thus oxidation of NADH by such dehydrogenases yields only 2 ATPs, as electrons pass through only 2 energy harvesting or proton translating complexes, that is complex 3rd and complex 4. Now, the second alternative pathway is that of alternative oxidase AO, which gives cyanide resistance to plants. One more unique aspect of plant mitochondria is the occurrence of an alternative oxidase, which is a quinol oxygen oxidoreductase. It is an iron containing protein which acts as a dimer and does not pump protons. This alternative oxidase is insensitive to cyanide. On oxidation of NADH, it accepts electrons from reduced ubiquinone and transfers them to oxygen, reducing it to water. Therefore, this alternative oxidase bypasses all cytochromes, cytocomplex 3rd, cytochrome C, complex 4 of electron transport chain, and thus also the two proton translocation sites. As this alternative oxidase does not pump protons, the energy released during electron transfer to oxygen is lost as heat. Thus, when alternative oxidase pathway become active in electron transport, only one ATP generated from the oxidation of NADH, the rest of the energy is lost as heat. This mechanism of heat generation by alternative oxidase pathway is exploited by some plants such as arum lily to attract pollinators by emitting volatile compounds as a result of heat generation in their flowers. Dear students, with this we come to the end of today's lecture. Hope this might have added to your knowledge. Thank you.